Hello friends, this is Dr. Rohit Shetty here. Today I'm going to discuss with you about a procedure which is commonly called as PRK or surface ablation. What is PRK and how is it different from LASIK is one of the most important questions which has been asked to refractive surgeons by the patient. And why do you select this for me? PRK is a procedure where we do not cut the cornea, but we reshape your cornea and take the power off by just ablating or just scraping off the cells on the surface. The cells on the surface can be scraped off using a laser or using a mechanical blade. Once the cells have been scraped off, and then the laser is given to correct the power. So why is PRK advised? PRK has a fundamental advantage of not trying to make the cornea weak. Fundamental advantage of trying to reduce the corneal dryness. Fundamental advantages of trying to be extremely safe in people with contact sports, army, air force, and those kind of activities. So when your surgeon decides to do on a PRK, there are various factors he goes in through it. How much is your power? How much is your strength of your cornea? How good is your corneal topography? And how this PRK procedure helps you in your contact sports or your profession, or you're involved in something where there's extreme conditions on the eye. So when you do a PRK, it's a little different as a procedure, because like I said, in a LASIK, you cut the flap, the machines like this, put it back, laser, put it back. So it heals faster, next day morning, you're able to see everything clearly. But when you do a PRK, it takes a little time. Because the cells which has been taken off has to re-go. During this time, we put a bandage contact lens. These bandage contact lens helps to improve in the healing and also reduce the pain. So when you heal, when this cornea heals, after 3 to 4 days time, there is hardly any difference between this and a LASIK. So when we advise PRK, it's for specific reasons and specific purpose. And trust me friends, this is one of the safest procedures in refractive surgery. Even in many countries, the fighter pilots, people who just don't want to have any cut on the corneas, still this is a preferred choice. What happens after you're done with the procedure? Like I said, a machine like this will correct it. You put a contact lenses, allow it to heal. You may experience some grittiness, some foreign body sensation, a little pain, mild pain in the first few hours. And then over time, it reduces. And after 2 days, you come back to us. We take the contact lenses off. You see like how you would see with the LASIK. So this is the whole concept about PRK. And I also given you an idea about when we choose a PRK. We choose PRK when the surgeons feel this is better. And how does the surgeon know it's better? By doing all the tests what has been done on you. The topography, the strength of the eye, the epithelial mapping, the dry eye, your profession, everything goes into that process. This is how we do it. And after a week or month, you hardly have a difference. Now, what are people scared about PRK? People are scared about, well, I think I have read somewhere that there is going to be pain in PRK. Are you sure that I'm not going to have pain? Me and my colleagues, we did some extraordinary good research work to figure out what can reduce the pain to a basic level, the baseline level. And that is something which we got published a few years back. We, instead of giving oral painkillers or putting drops of painkillers, we soak the contact lenses in a painkiller solution, which is kept in an overnight fridge with the cold BCL or the contact lenses, and we put it on the eye. It drastically reduced the pain to very minimal one. And trust me, friends, we have done close to 3,000 or 4,000 of these procedures. And after we started doing this, our pain threshold has come down drastically. So that is one major factor, which is how. The second thing what you see and hear on internet is about, will it cause scarring? Because you're not cutting the eye like your LASIK, you're actually burning the surface. Scarring is one of the most important challenges which we had in the past. But what happens is we have techniques now, beautiful laser platforms which can actually reduce the scarring or no scarring to a very, very minimal level. And even if there is minimal, we can always treat it with steroids and other things to reduce it so that you don't have to worry about it. So in the last few thousand eyes, we have not had anybody with great amount of scarring. So these are the two important things. Sometimes there is some delay in the healing of epithelium, and we may have to keep bandage contact lens for some time. Some people may have a little extra pain, dryness, and all these factors are always going to be there. The third point is how PRK is done. Like I mentioned, it's about taking the epithelium off and doing with the laser. But what we do in our system, in our hospital, is using one of the world's most advanced PRK machine called Schwendemaris, 1000 Hertz. It's one of the fastest known machine. So what it does is, at one go, it takes the epithelium, which is the outer layer, and then corrects the power. Even if I'm treating, say, -5 or -6, just hardly takes 22, 23 seconds to knock it off and treat completely. And we personally have figured out that it reduces pain, it also improves faster healing, and also has a huge impact on the kind of healing and haze we get. So, three important points is why the surgeons have decided, and I told you, the surgeons, way he decides is based on multiple factors. Two, what are the major myths and fear? It's about pain, scarring, delayed wound healing, and all these factors. But friends, let me tell you, even if it delays the wound healing, even if there's a delay in what you, in your vision, quality of vision, what you see, if a surgeon feels that this is safe for you, please go for it, because he or she knows what he's doing. And the surgeon knows that this is going to be safer in 10 years' time. Just 1 or 2 days of a mild comfort and sacrificing that strength of the cornea is not good. So if a surgeon feels this is good, go ahead. No question asked. The third thing is the machines we use. And the machines we use are very important, because when we use advanced machines or technologies, like I mentioned, the Schwendemaris, our Alcon also has the machine, it's called Streamline. Your ability to treat and make it refined is very good. So post-operatively, what to expect? First day, as soon as you finish, little watering, pain, blurring. You put a contact lens, which subsides in few hours' time. Next 2 days, there'll be still little amount of blurred vision. You'll not be able to see clearly. Once I remove the lenses, after the second or third day, you start seeing clearly. Sometimes I do one eye at a time, sometimes I do both eyes at times. The most important thing is that it is all left to the discretion of the surgeon. Whichever is safe, he or she will decide for you. And then after 1 week, you will hardly see a difference between both the procedures. So when you're doing this procedure, do not jump and have multiple things planned in this week. Give a good 5 or 6 days time for you to plan this procedure. The reason is, if I take care of you by doing this procedure, which for you is the best, it's going to take care of you and your vision for the next 50, 100 years you're going to live in. So friends, PRK is not as scary as it should be. It's a safe procedure. And if your surgeon asks you to go for it, please do it.